Sunspots are getting bigger and more numerous. This can only mean the end of the world. Or, you know, business as usual. It's a toss-up. Hey there, stargazers and soothsayers. Julian here for DNews. The sun is a mass of incandescent gas, a gigantic nuclear furnace. Everyone knows that. But there's a lot more going on than just slamming hydrogen together. Not that that isn't pretty sweet on its own. The sun, like most celestial bodies, is also rotating on an axis. Big deal, right? Well, the cool part is it's not all rotating at the same speed. Because the exterior of the sun isn't a solid crust like Earth's, the equator of the sun is actually spinning much faster than the poles. If you were standing on the sun's equator, you would make a trip around it in 25 days. Whereas if you were standing by the poles, it would take 36 days to make a revolution. That's kind of like standing on Panama and surfing it until you're just south of Russia 12 hours later. And when you factor in that the sun's plasma is linked to its magnetic field, things get twisted. Literally. After a while, the magnetic field lines look like your headphones after you left them in your pocket, and then put your pants through the dryer. The magnetic field in turn has an effect on the convection layer of the sun, meaning some areas don't get piping hot 5,500 degrees Celsius plasma from the sun's interior, and the stagnating plasma on the surface cools to a frigid 2,700 to 4,200 degrees Celsius. These areas are still giving off light, but compared to the rest of the sun, they look black. And that's what we call sunspots. And because they're areas of intense magnetic twistification, sunspots tend to be where solar flares and coronal mass ejections originate. Basically, the magnetic field lines snap and sling matter and electromagnetic radiation and massive amounts of energy off into space. And pretty soon, a great big sunspot is going to be pointing right at us. The sexily named AR2192 has been getting bigger and bigger as it rotates toward us. Its solar flares are crossing the threshold to the X-class, meaning they have the potential to briefly knock out radio communications planet-wide, and I bet you anything it'll happen during the World Series. If you watched the partial solar eclipse yesterday, you could even see it with the naked eye. Side note, do not watch a solar eclipse with the naked eye. Surely this is the harbinger of doom. Well, not really. Sunspots are on an 11-year cycle. They get bigger and more numerous for a while, and then the magnetic field untangles itself, and we do it all over again. Now, if only the same trick worked with those headphones. If you want to find out what happens when the Earth's magnetic fields reverse, I'd like to draw your attention to Tara's video down here. Is there another apocalyptic scenario you want us to look into? Let us know in the comments, and thanks for watching DNews. Or if you watch the eclipse unprotected, thanks for listening.